What's up, everybody? Today we are going to learn the basics of Adobe InDesign. Adobe InDesign is your one-stop shop for everything that is publication layout. I'm going to go ahead and hit New File. Once we're in New File, we're greeted with a few different presets. For this demo, we're going to lay out a print preset. I'm going to go to the Print option and then choose View All Presets. You can see you have a lot of different options here. There's even some templates that you could use and download. For this demo, we're going to stick to the A4 demo. We're going to kind of do a pseudo magazine layout just to get you comfortable in the software. So we're going to go ahead and hit A4. We're going to give this 3 pages. There we go. And we're going to go down here. I always like to set mine instead of to pixels to inches. We're going to call this magazine layout. Scroll down. For my bleed, I'm going to set this to 0.125. This is a pretty common bleed for a document, so I'm going to go ahead and put that in there. We can also hit preview, which is a really nice tool. Once I hit create, that's going to give me this document. That's going to give me, as you can see, a single cover page. If I hold my hand tool and navigate down to the bottom, you're going to notice that I have my first spread. Well, what's happening here? If I hit Z and my Alt key and hit my left mouse button, I can see that I've created 3 unique pages. I have a Pages tab here in InDesign in which those 3 pages are displayed. I have my Properties panel in which I could go ahead and make necessary changes depending on the size, or if I wanted to adjust any sort of rules for the paper, so to speak, I could go ahead and do that. I could even turn off facing pages and these would just be singular documents. You have kind of that layout there for you to work on. We're going to kind of avoid the cover at the moment, and I'm going to just show you a little bit on how to navigate the spread itself. For this spread, typically when you're working in InDesign, it's a lot like building a slideshow in PowerPoint or Google Slides. You do kind of have what's called master pages that we will create, and I'll cover that in another tutorial. But the master pages are essentially like your master slides, and you can set up different layouts, different page numbers, and it speeds things up. But for our sake, we're gonna just kind of dive into this look. I'm gonna start by going to my rectangle tool, or M on my keyboard. I'm gonna draw a rectangle right here over this area. This is gonna be my centered area. Once I'm in that, I'll go to the properties of that rectangle, and I'm gonna just bump the stroke up a few points so you can kind of see this kind of placeholder. I can then click on the color and we could make it perhaps red or blue. It's really up to you. I didn't mean to rhyme on that, but it sounded good. I'm going to click away and there it goes. Now, in order to not continually move this, I'm going to go ahead and lock this. So if I hit Control L, I'm going to lock that. That's just a layer. You're going to see I have layers just like any other Adobe program in my layers panel. It's not hidden or anything like that. Next, I want to set up my grid. I could just start dragging and dropping text in here, but I want to do this pretty orderly. What I'm going to do is I'm going to go up to the Layout tab, and I'm going to play a little bit with the margins and columns. And in margins and columns, I'm going to do a few little tricks. First, I'm going to go ahead and do six columns. If I want 6 total columns, I can do 3 on each side. As you can see, I have 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. The gutters are in between them. I can go ahead and change that gutter side as I see fit. I could adjust the gutter spacing. So if I wanted less spacing or more spacing, I like this 0.18. I can play with the inside and outside margins. This is lining up pretty good for me though. I'm gonna just kind of keep it as is for demo sake and hit okay. The next step is I need some horizontal guides. For that, I'm gonna go to Layout, Create Guides. In Create Guides, I'm gonna go and add just a few different rows in which I can use as visual guides. So maybe 4 in this case, maybe even 3. You can break it up into thirds if you need to. What I'm gonna do then is kill this gutter. I just want a singular line here. This is just kind of to break my grid into threes. I'm going to hit OK there. Now that I have my layout, I have a little bit of a better chance on figuring out where to lay out text. So text and imagery are pretty easy in InDesign. You can import them from separate documents. You can create your own. What we're going to do is we're going to start with a rectangular frame. That rectangular frame, we're going to go ahead and we're going to put this frame on the right-hand side of our image using those guides. This is going to act as our picture. To get this to look correct, I'm going to go ahead and drag and drop an image into this container. I have an image that I have off screen here that you can see. I'm going to just drag it and let it go. And at first glance, this is a really zoomed in shot of my image. I'm going to right click on this image. I'm going to go back to my selection tool, right click. I'm going to go to fitting. Let's go ahead and fit content proportionally. That's great. Looking good. It gives us pretty even guidelines. One thing you may know right now is you're noticing the pixelization of this image. This is just to speed up the process. So if I go to view and I go to display performance, you're going to see that there's all different types of display performance. For instance, you have things like fast display, high quality display. When you push that, if you have a faster computer, that's going to give you that look. No matter what you select, even if it looks pixelated, when you export it, it will not come out pixelated. Do not worry there. The next step is for us to draw some grids. I'm going to do the same thing here. I'm going to use my type tool, though. I think I'm going to draw, kind of match up these grid lines right here. That's going to give me a text box, which is really nice. And one cool thing about the text box, if you don't have current text, you can simply right click in it. Once you're in that text, you can find the fill with placeholder text. We can fill that up and it's looking really good. And if I hit Shift W, you're going to see a preview of our layout. You can see we need a little bit more spacing here. So I'll Shift W again. We'll just kind of adjust that as we see fit. Maybe we'll pull that in just ever so slightly. Okay, now that we have that image, I kind of want to break this up into columns. So if I were to break this up into columns, and maybe we'll make this about half the size here, I could do that relatively easily. I'm going to right click on the text again and go to text frame options. What that is going to give me, and this is really cool, you're going to select the preview. I can go ahead and separate this into three columns. I just want to essentially make sure that my numbers kind of match what I originally set up. You can go and play with this as you see fit, and it's going to look really nice. As you can see, everything looks good. I could even create a rule that constantly has this. So if I want to insert a column rule, for instance, if I want a stroke in between each one of these, if they're different types of language, I could totally do that. When I hit OK, let's hit Shift W again. We now have a really nice layout. Shift W. All right. If they're going over your necessary column width, do not fret. You can always, once again, click in there and go back to that text frame options and change that as you see fit. But I'm liking what I have right here. This is actually looking pretty good. Next, you'll notice when I click here, I have this little red bar. This is referring to overflow text. Let's say I don't want this image to be the whole page. So let's bring this down and kind of make it two columns worth. We'll move the text box, make it like here. These are very forgiving. Right click, we can go to fitting and you can fit frame proportionally. So now that's nice in the center. And let's say I had a couple other text boxes down here. If I drag this out, I can drag that out there. Can start typing if I wish, but a really cool thing is if I want to take the remainder of the text here and link it to this box, it's really easy. I'm going to just go to my overflow text, which is this little red line, and it's really easy. Once I double click on it, I can just then click on this element over here and it will fill that. As you can see, it has now filled. If I hit Shift W, we are working with something. And once again, I can do adjustments on my text box rather easily. Maybe I decide to pull this frame down a little bit, just center that up. Love having my grid, right click, fitting, and we can do something like fill content. content proportionally. Let's hit Shift W, and there we go. Now, if you wanted the three column grid again, you just hit your V key, text frame options, and you could break that up into two columns, three columns, you name it. We're going to stick to kind of the three column grid here. We could adjust that spacing to kind of match what we like. That's pretty close there. I like to preview off and on, and now we have it. Next, I'm going to go ahead and put a title. So over here, we're going to put some text. We're going to do camping for the summer. That doesn't look very title-like, but that's okay because I have tons of options in my character palette to make this more impactful. I can go ahead and choose really any of these typefaces. I'm going to choose like a bold ultra black, and I'm going to really scale this up. And it's going to break the text, as you can see, where the text box is. That's not really a problem, but we can go ahead and put that in. That's looking really great. We can even tighten this up if we want to. Center it up a little bit inside those grids. All right, we now have camping for the summer, and we'll kind of scooch this over. Maybe give it a little more room to bump it up just slightly more. Get to those edges. Awesome. Now, if I want to create a title style, I can do that. We have paragraph styles and character styles. So let's say I want to continue to make this title on other pages. I don't want to have to redo that sizing again. I could easily do that by adding a new paragraph style. What this will be called is title. What that means is anytime I go to type something, so if I do another box here, and I say title, real small. I wanted that to be a title on another page. I could just select the title page font and scale this out, and it's going to fix itself to that. Another great thing about those paragraph styles are if you go ahead and want to edit them, you can just open the drop down and edit them as you see fit. You can change things like color, for instance, or shading. So you can go to character color. Maybe I'll make this blue. And we can set the preview there, or we can make it dark to match that kind of background. It's going to update on every single page, which is a really nice feature. Now that we have kind of this setup and things are looking good, we can kind of go through and kind of do maybe a couple more edits here. Let's draw another text box, and we'll get our text tool here and draw this out, and we'll say the top five places you need to visit in summer 2024. All right, this is kind of our subheading. We can open this up a little bit, and maybe we'll pick a less intense typeface here. So that looks good. And we'll just open this up a little bit. That looks great. And see what we got. Shift W, looking really good. We can align these as well. So you can hold shift to select different kind of levels and then scroll down to your align tool. It's really a forgiving way to kind of create this kind of flow of layout. You can see it's rather easy. Maybe I want to have a couple pictures here later on and I'm just not sure what they are. So I could draw that. I could go back to my move tool. I could hold Alt, just like we were in Illustrator, and I could duplicate those frames so they match in each segment. You can even see now there's a text image to beta. If we wanted to say camper on mountain, we could go ahead and hit generate, and we'll hit agree here. We'll let that run for a few seconds. Now we have a camper. Now it took it literally and it read this as a camper, not like a camper, like an RV. So again, you got to be really careful with what you write, but we can go ahead and fit frame proportionally. If I want to double click in that, I can then move that up to show our camper just so he's in the frame. stretch it just a little bit. I love that. Also, if I don't want to use generative text, I could right-click and do search Adobe Stock. This is another thing that will open Adobe Stock within our scene and allow us to pull fun ones in. So don't sleep on that. Maybe I want to have kind of a longer image here. Let me delete this and then let's stretch this out. Using those guides is really, really helpful. I'll drag my other image in I got from Adobe Stock. I'll double click and we will fit this content proportionally. And we'll just kind of pull this out as we see fit and then shift W. Look at that, y'all. We have a pretty cool magazine layout. Now to export this, it's really easy. We're gonna go to File, Export, and we're gonna just make sure it's set to a magazine layout and a PDF print. You're gonna pick where you wanna send that. You're gonna export it. You can choose all of the different elements. If you wanna do spreads or individual pages, let's do spreads and we'll hit export. This is telling us that there's over text, meaning that there's more text that is written. We don't need to worry about that because we're using placeholder text, and we'll let that run. Give that a few seconds, and on our desktop, we should have a magazine layout. Let's open that up. Of course, the first page is going to be blank, but if we go down to the bottom page, we'll go ahead and fit this in our screen here. I might zoom out. There we go. We have a pretty cool magazine layout ready to go. I hope you enjoyed this lesson, and I hope it gives you a little bit of an idea of how powerful InDesign is for quickly laying out different types of layouts, whether it's magazines, flyers, it could be your portfolio. I can't wait to see what you all create. I'll catch you in the next tutorial.